Another way to allow or disallow access to resources is through something called an access control list. You may hear this referred to as ACLs or as ACLs. The access control lists are things that you would assign to an object or a network that would allow permission to that object or that network. You see, access control lists use in many different environments, in file systems, network devices, operating systems. It's a very, very common way of setting up permissions to particular resources. And for instance, this is the way you do an access control list, to be listing out permissions of a file, for instance. In this access control list, Bob can read the files, Fred can access the network, James can access the network 192.168.1.0/24 using TCP ports 8443 and 8088. So you can have very generalized access controls in your access control list or very specific access controls in your access control list. Here's a good example of an access control list that might be inside of a firewall. Here's access list. All of this is a member of the first access list in the firewall. Here's a deny access control that says if you are on 172.16.5.2 with this mask, which means really this IP address, we're going to deny any traffic from that IP address. So that locks it out. Here's another one, access control list. We're going to deny 172.16.5.3. So the first two of these rules in this access control list are denying traffic to individual IP addresses. And here's the last access control that says permit any, which means if you aren't 172.16.5.2 or 172.16.5.3, everybody else is allowed to communicate. That's a very simple access control list, but it gives you an idea of looking at a router or looking at a firewall, the process it goes through to go down that list and allow or disallow access to resources on the network.